Everybody knows that Warner Brothers is in the Harry Potter business and the DC business, but it's also worth noting that they're very much in the Ben Affleck business, both behind the camera and in front of it. In fact, the studio has worked very hard to make themselves the sandbox within which Ben Affleck can creatively, you know, fulfill his grandest wishes, from being a comic book superhero, something he's always wanted to do and said led to the bad decision of being a Daredevil, but also to his wanting to be a director and to prove that he's actually a talented individual, because for a while there, we weren't so sure. Warner Brothers distributed The Town. They distributed Argo. We'll revisit that in just a moment because it plays very much into this Live by Night trailer. But it's worth noting that going forward, Ben Affleck is exclusively making Warner Brothers movies. He's, of course, not only the face of Warner Brothers, but I think arguably the DCEU as Batman, also going to behind the camera there as well to direct the solo Batman movie. And he also has The Accountant coming up. And of course, Live by Night is a Warner Brothers movie. Now, I said I wanted to mention Argo. Argo was a huge Oscar winner. It was a very strong film for Warner Brothers and Ben Affleck, both in terms of box office and awards wins. But as you might recall, there was quite the scandal when Ben Affleck was not even nominated for Best Director for the picture. And many people feel that Argo won Best Picture kind of as the Academy voters trying to right that wrong. So I can understand the pressure that he must be feeling for Live by Night to prove that, you know, that wasn't a pity Oscar and that he truly is a director worthy of being outrightly nominated for the directing category. And maybe that history will correct itself with an actual nomination for directing and maybe even a win for Live by Night. So let's take a look at this. He continues to star in his own films. Let's see if he is not only as good as he did a job in Argo, but is perhaps even improving as a filmmaker. And of course, now that he's in the DCEU, you can bet that everybody is going to be looking at this saying, what clues can we take away from this to show us what a Batman movie might look like? That's the pros and cons. You know, it's a double-edged sword being part of the DCEU. You know, there's a much greater interest in your work because of that involvement, but at the same time, it's a filter that all your work is looked at through. All right, so let's actually look at this.
Even if you win today's battle, there's so much violence in what you do.
Old-fashioned The Town.
You don't think I'm strong enough?
I don't know if you're cruel enough.
Powerful men don't have to be cruel.
Yes, they do.
I signed up to fight in the war. I went away a soldier. I came home an outlaw.
We do what we want to do. We go where we want to go.
Just the money.
I don't want to be a gangster. I stopped kissing rings a long time ago.
It no longer matters what you want. You're in this life.
My father says there once was a good man in you.
We all find ourselves in lives we didn't expect.
Repent. Repent. Repent.
This is heaven. Right here. We're in it now.
I knew that something would always rule.
You spend your life hoping someone will punish you for your sins.
I knew the scent was mine alone.
Well, here I am.
What you put out into this world will always come back to you. But it never comes back how you predict.
Breaking the rules meant nothing. You had to be strong enough to make your own.
It's a good one. Did you find out if you are as cruel as you need to be?
Don't you ever tame your demons. Always keep them on a leash.
Alrighty. Good news and bad news. The good news is, is that that looks incredibly well directed. Really, really well directed. I think that he's getting better. So, and in fact, I thought it was so cinematic and so well structured that it does make me more excited for the Batman movie. And I didn't think I could get more excited for the. I don't know if I am more excited for the Batman movie because I was already at an 11, but it makes me feel like my confidence is like rewarded. It's like evidence. I'm like, oh, it's not just a leap of faith anymore. Have you seen the Live by Night trailer? My only problem with it is that, and I think it's a great role for Ben Affleck. You know, he has to escape the shadow of Boardwalk Empire a little bit, but lucky for him, a lot of people weren't watching that show toward the end, so it's not on a lot of people's minds. But I will say, you know, I like, actually, I think the whole cast is weak. I think that, you know, it's no Argo with Alan Arkin and John Goodman. I think that, you know, Brendan Gleeson, you know, respected, obviously, Chris Cooper, but, you know, Chris Messina, he's from, I believe, the Mindy Project, and so he's actually very funny on the Mindy Project, but geez, okay? And then also, there've got to be better actresses that could have been put here. You know, Elle Fanning is talented. Zoe Saldana looks great as someone who would potentially, you know, I think they're doing like the whole New York to Florida situation. And, you know, Zoe Saldana could perhaps be playing like someone from Cuba, right? And that whole setup. But at this point, Zoe Saldana, I think that I know she's in Guardians of the Galaxy, I know she's in Avatar, but, you know, when she isn't painted in, you know, blue or green, she really struggles at the box office. You know, audiences just aren't interested in her work. Same for Sienna Miller. I feel like there's got to be better actresses working today. I know there are, and if not, go find them. I just think, you know, I was going to say that I wish that the actresses were of the caliber of the actors, but I think that they're not, the actors aren't particularly strong either. But, you know, Ben Affleck, this is, you know, I think that very much means the whole movie rests on him. And it looks like he's able to hold it up, right? He looks like I don't know if he's cruel enough, but I think he's strong and talented enough. So let's see. But I liked it. I liked it a lot. And I'll be curious to see how the actual film plays out. I think, I'm not sure how it'll fare as an awards contender, maybe because it is such a showcase piece. It doesn't seem more like the ensemble kind of piece that Argo did. It's going to have to be really, really good to move beyond a crowd pleaser. I think this will probably do very well with audiences. Well, again, I don't know, because I think that Sienna Miller and Zoe Saldana are very, very weak. But I think that maybe we'll see if he has a little a DCEU boost with a lot of people going to see the new Batman movie, right? All right. So what do you think? What do you think of the trailer? What do you think of it not only as, you know, for Ben Affleck, but as a film as a whole? And do you think that a lot of people will go see this beyond the hardcore, you know, DC fans? Do you think this is something that, you know, could be a strong contender during awards season? Write your thoughts down below. Thank you so much for tuning in. And you can check out some more episodes right now.